Violett Beane is best known for her role as Jessie Quick in CW's The Flash, but now you can catch her in CBS's dramedy series, God Friended Me. The show follows an outspoken atheist whose life is turned upside down when he receives a friend request on social media from God. Take a look.
You saved John Dove and he saved me. If you think about it, it's kind of like a grand design.
I want to be a part of your life.
When you pulled me back, I realized, you know, I didn't want to die. Thank you.
People say that God has a plan for all of us. Well, I never believed that to be true.
But then he friended me, and it kind of turned my life upside down. Not that I think it's God, but in these crazy times we live in, we owe it to ourselves to ask the tough questions.
Wait a minute. You don't think Dad is behind this, do you?
Really, Miles? He can't even use Netflix.
Everyone, please give a warm Bill Bunch welcome to Violett Beane. Violett, we're so excited for you to be here.
Thank you.
First question, is Violett your favorite color?
Well, clearly today.
Yeah, yes. You're really pulling off.
And I actually did all this myself.
That's
so
great.
Maybe it is my favorite color, and I've just decided that.
Yeah. Well, I love it. Well, this show is so interesting and great, and I remember when it was launched on CBS, it was such a game changer. But for those people who maybe haven't seen it, can you tell us about the show?
Yeah, so it's about an outspoken atheist who gets friended by someone calling themselves God on Facebook. That's the whole sort of premise of the show is it God or is it someone behind this Facebook account? And the show in itself is more about the connectivity of people and how we can be there for each other, because what happens each episode is Miles, my character Kara, and Rakesh, their friend, get a friend suggestion for someone. And they basically have to figure out what is going on in this person's life and what they need help for. And it can be, you know, something's not going right with their job, or they haven't talked to their sister in years and they need to reconnect with them. And so we kind of help them figure that out and work through it.
That's great. And so season one just wrapped. How has it been? How's the journey been for season, you know, on the first season of the show?
It's been so amazing. I mean, none of us lived here in New York, so being here and filming and like being on the streets pretty much
which
every
is so
day.
Unique for an broadcast show if you actually film in New York.
Absolutely. And like our show, I think, is almost like a passport to the city. Mm-hmm. Like each episode will be in Central Park or will be in Columbus Circle or we'll be somewhere that's like significantly New York City. Mm-hmm. And I think that's really fun.
Yeah, I mean, and so it got renewed for a second season. Congratulations. Yeah. It's like the top rated show on Sunday nights on broadcast, which
Fantastic.
Is incredible. Like, over 10 million people are watching it every day. What does it feel like to be on, you know, CBS, which was the most watched network, and to be on one of their most watched shows?
I mean, it's amazing. I think having an audience that large is awesome, especially for what it is, the message that we're trying to tell. Mm-hmm. And I think that, you know, having a show out there that sort of sends positivity and uplifting messages instead of, you know, war and violence, which I love also. I love to watch that, but I think it's nice to have that message every single week for families and kids who are coming together and watching this together.
Right. Yeah. And season two probably is being written right now.
Yeah.
But can you tease anything? Do you know if anything's going to happen next season?
I don't know much, but in the final episode of season one, there is a new person who gets the friend suggestion
Ooh.
From God.
Hmm.
So I'm excited to see where that goes.
Very exciting. That.
Yeah.
Ooh, I was hoping for maybe Satan on Facebook.
Yeah.
I'm down. I mean,
yeah, that'd be great.
Shannon's
yeah.
personal friend.
Yeah.
Satan.
Yeah, I'm a Satanist, so I just would love to see this for a little bit more Satan-y.
Yeah, how far back do you guys go?
Oh, really far, but since I probably was seven or eight when I was like, the Dark Lord.
it's your person, all right.
Yeah, just if you want to do like a spin-off, we could do it together.
Let's chat after this and figure it out.
Oh, yeah,
I love it.
Yay, we have plans. But could you tell us more about your character and how was the audition process?
Okay, so I play Kara Bloom, and she's an online journalist, and she's the first friend suggestion that Miles gets. And when you first meet her, she's dealing with the fact that her mom left when she was really young, and she actually has found her again in New York City, but doesn't know how to take the next step. Mm-hmm. And Miles and the God account help her do that, so she sticks around to help everyone else. And the audition process was a lot like most actors. Pilot season, auditioning 17 times a day, no joke.
Yeah.
And, you know, and it was one of like the, towards the end of the season, I was like, okay, so I didn't book a show this year. Got it. And I went in and the guys in the room were just so fabulous. Our producers and our showrunners. And there's just like this energy and we all left kind of feeling like, wait, did that just happen? And they've told me the story so many times being like, we were so happy to have found you. Like they had tested the role previously, it didn't work out. Like they were also like thinking they weren't gonna find it. So it was really kismet.
Yeah.
Wow, I love that. And obviously Facebook is a huge part of the show. That's how God's talking to you guys. So like, are you personally like into social media? Like was Facebook like involved at all?
No, we're not getting money from Facebook.
Really
I know.
I feel like you're putting Facebook back on the
map. Honestly, yeah,
like,
you're improving Mark Zuckerberg's reputation on the show, I think.
I'm not.
No, we're blaming you.
No, but I prefer social media with Instagram, not with Facebook so
which
much.
Which is also Facebook.
Technically, yeah. I know. Ooh.
They got us.
I know, they did. Yeah, and we all know it, too. That's the worst part.
Yeah. I'd love to see God's Instagram.
Oh.
Probably a lot of great cloud pics.
Yeah, right? Just all clouds.
All clouds.
Like,
look at this one, guys. Cool.
Fun fact, God tried to airdrop me on the train the other day, and I didn't accept it, and now I'm like, did I miss out on a blessing?
Probably.
But I actually think it was just some weirdo dropping me a picture of Mickey Mouse saying,
I've done that, yo. Yeah. I went to an airport and I was trying to send it to my boyfriend who was sitting next to me and I like saw like four different people pop up and I was like, yeah. And I sent it. I sent them like cute pictures of us on the beach.
You sent them personal pics?
Yeah.
Wow. I thought you were like sending memes.
No.
Just sending bikini pics to strangers?
You're
like a dream come true.
Well, like, okay, so it was like a guy and like his four friends and they were like, they like look up from their phone, they're like, hey, what? And then they like look at each other and like, should I accept? And they decline. And so I sent it again like three times. It was great. It's fun. I highly recommend.
So what's it like working with the cast?
They're fabulous. Our cast and crew are so cool. And like, I'm not just saying that because a lot of times you like have to say that.
Mm-hmm. We're family.
Yeah.
It's us like, too.
Yeah.
We love each other, yeah.
But no, everyone's great, and our crew is really fabulous, and like everyone's like young and like free spirited and like down to work, which also is not always the case. So yeah,
that's really great. Grateful. Sounds fun. Any fun moments behind the scenes?
I mean, every day, like honestly, something crazy happens, especially in New York City. Like we were filming in Central Park, and this guy walks up to me and Brandon, my co-star. And we're like about to like do this walk and talk and it's like really serious. And he like comes up and he's like, hey, I like your mustache. And he's like, oh, thanks, man. And he's like, I was talking to her.
Oh.
Like, all right, cool.
Nothing like New York.
Yeah.
You also play Jesse Quick on The Flash, which we all know and love. So what has been the most fun part about that role?
The best part about Jesse Quick was definitely getting the costume. When I first booked the role, I thought that she would start with powers. And it was actually like an entire year later when she finally got them. So like that moment was probably the most epic. Yeah. And like the whole crew was there with me and like they were like, this is so cool.
What was it like putting on that suit every day? Did it like build your confidence immediately?
Oh, it was really tight and warm and sweaty. Yeah. That's the honest truth. Most of it was like leather. Yeah. And it didn't stretch at all. I couldn't bend my arms like more than this.
Oh, geez.
But no, it was great.
Would you play another superhero going forward knowing that?
You know, I would. I think they're fabulous. I think that like they're strong and especially female superheroes, like they have a special quality about them that I think people are doing really right. Mm-hmm. So yeah, I would love to.
I love that. And you obviously have this amazing show happening, but what else is going on with you? Anything else we can look out for?
Right now I'm on hiatus and I'm taking full advantage. And I'm actually gonna go back to my hometown, which I haven't been back to in a few years, so I'm really excited. But yeah, just kicking it, hanging out.
Enjoy your summer.
Thank you.
Yes. You work too hard.
Well, Violett, thank you so much for joining us. This was a lot of fun.